Hello, welcome to today's webinar, Innovative Drag and Drop Hardware Development for Embedded Devices. The webinar is hosted by Toradex and we are joined by our partner, Altium. My name is Daniel Lang and I'm the CMO of Toradex. Today's webinar, we have two additional speakers. So we have Andrew Smith and Keith Lee, both from Altium. Andrew is a manager for product development and engineering, smart manufacturing, and he's located in Canada. Keith is a software engineer, also for smart manufacturing, and he's also located in Canada. Before we dive into the webinar, a few organizational points. Please use the chat window of the webinar tool if you have any technical issues. At the end of the session, we will have a live Q&A and you can type your questions already now into the webinar tool and we will pick them up at the end. We will also have poll questions throughout the webinar, so make sure you pay attention so you're ready to answer them. The webinar tool will be recorded, so we will be able to watch the webinar as an on-demand service later. Also, you can see today we have a video feed and the webinar tool allows you to adjust your video window and your slide window. So please do so that it works well for you. Today's agenda, first, we will have a very brief Toradex intro. Then we will look at the different ways how you can get a carrier board. Then there will be a Geppetto intro. Keith will give you a demonstration so you can live experience how it is to use the tool. Then Andrew will talk about the path to volume production. We have a promotion, so a few words about that. And then at the end, we will pick up your questions and answer them. So what is Toradex doing? So Toradex is focusing on making embedded computing easy. We do that by providing reliable ARM system on modules, including software and support. We strive to provide you the lowest cost of ownership. That doesn't mean just the price of the module, that also includes time to market, maintenance of the hard and software down the road. We have industry-leading support, and that also includes a developer web page with over 800 articles we update daily and a very active community. As you can see here on the map, we have offices all around the world. In these offices, we have local support and there are also service as warehouses. Our product portfolio is mostly ARM system on modules. We have three families. Within these families, the modules are pin compatible, so you can upgrade and downgrade. So for example, you can switch from i.MX6 to i.MX7 to i.MX8. In today's webinar, in the demo area, we will use the Verdin, so the module on the bottom, and we are it will be the Verdin Mini, and we will also have a Verdin i.MX 8 and Plus coming out very soon, and this module even feature neural network accelerators. Even we mostly sell hardware, we put actually most of our engineering into software, and I like to highlight one of the software offerings here. So this is Torizon. It's an easy to use industrial Linux software platform, and the focus is time to market. So it's ready to use out of the box. It's a binary distribution you can directly use, and it also comes with a wide range of tools, and one of that tools is called Toradex Core Builder. And Toradex Core Builder allows you to import hardware configuration files into the tool. So for example, later you will hear Geppetto creates a device tree, which basically describes the configuration of a hardware. And here in Torizon, you can just load that file and then your system on module is ready for your carrier board. Torizon is open source. We provide a simple update. It's an automotive grade, safe and secure update solution. And we also have new hosted version, so you can host your updates with us. Currently, that runs an experiment on our labs page, but very soon we will also launch it as a commercial product. Security is a focus. We provide frequent updates and we provide access to the hardware security features. There is a real-time option. And the Torizon is built with the Yocto project, so you can even customize it if you like. It utilizes Docker software containerization, so you can tap in that ecosystem. Now, I think it's always interesting to learn a little bit about the typical application, so you can learn for what our products, our services, our partner optimize the solution. So our top markets are industrial automation, healthcare, transportation, test and measurement, and smart city, which include things like building automation. Typically, our customer have volumes from 100 to a couple 10,000 pieces per year, and many run them for many years, 5, 10, 15 years is not uncommon. With that, we are at the end of the Toradex introduction, and we have the first poll. So here the question is, how experienced are you with hardware design? Did you do a layout and schematic design for actual products, or you know about it at least, or you know layout and schematics on that level, that's not your field of expertise. So please make your choice. So a few seconds left here, and then we will look all together at the results. So we can see, so everybody has basically experienced, some of them are very experienced, did hardware design. So today you will learn something. You may don't need to type in all of these skills, at least not in the prototype phase. And then most of you, they know a little bit about it. And I think that's probably the perfect skill level for what we show you today. Good. Now talking about carrier boards. So before we dive into that, a very short recap why we even use system on module. And I don't cover all the points here, just a few selected one. So first, system on module really encapsulate the complexity, for example, of the hardware design. So high speed design, wireless connectivity, power management, all of that is encapsulated in the module. And in case of Toradex, that also comes with a production quality software. Also, most of the software stack is actually only depending on the module. So you can tap into the work we do around software, the ecosystem we build ourselves and with our partner, and you can take full advantage of that. Also, you get scalability. As mentioned before, you can up and downgrade. Now, what's the job of the carrier board? So the carrier board allows you to still build a fully customized design or a customized design. You can customize the form factor, the connectors, the peripherals, and so on. But because you use a system on module, you have a lower risk for that project and you are faster to market. So how can you get a carrier board? So we have a few different ways. So if you want to use a ready-to-use carrier board, so you don't want to design or customize, you directly want to get started, it's very similar to what you would do with a single board computer, then we have this option. So we have our development boards, they're designed for development, so they have a few additional features, and many of them have chamber areas, so you can emulate different kind of pin configuration. They have USB to serial adapters for easy development, they have LED switches on board and a lot of things just to make your life easy as a development tool. If you need a board you can use in production, we also have different solutions. So first, Toradex provides a few selected board you can use and deploy directly in volume production. Or you can tap into our partner. Many of our partners provide carrier boards out of the box to use for different applications that ranges from ruggedized vehicle computers to a system for HMIs and so on. Also, what I like to highlight is that the development boards and the Toradex production boards, they're also reference designs. So they're fully open source. You can look at them and use that as a base for your own customization. Now, if you really want to take advantage of a system on module, you probably build, you want to have a customized carrier board. So most popular is do it yourself. As I said, you have a reference designs, you have design guides, you have tools like pinout designer tool and so on to make that easy. It's probably the most popular option. Alternative, again, you can work with our proven partner network. Proven partner means these customers or these partners did successful projects with our customer, and you trust them that they can get you to market very fast. So some of these partners, they have design only. They just do the design for you. Some, they do the design and manufacture. So they basically deliver a board to you. And then we have other ones that can do the whole product development case, sometimes even software. But now, today we talk about a third option basically here, and that's between. So Geppetto tool allows you to do the design yourself. So you have a lot of control, kind of do it yourself, but you don't need to go down and do actually the routing and the schematic yourself. But you will learn more about that from Andrew and Keith. And with that, I would hand over to Andrew.
There we go. Thank you very much, Daniel. All right, at Altium, we're really excited to be partnering with Toradex because we feel that Geppetto represents a significant step and advancement in how you design. And as Daniel mentioned, Toradex, the Torizon, is all about trying to get time to market and cost to market as well. And that's exactly what Geppetto is designed to do. Instead of focusing on the kind of the nuts and bolts of being putting together resistors, capacitors, these chips, you are focused on a higher level development. So you're looking at, okay, what do I want to get out of this? So almost like at a software level, what's my goal of this product? And that's kind of your design level. You're dragging in functional blocks that have all the nuts and bolts built into it, and then you connect it together from there. So because you don't have all that extra, I guess, that overhead of knowing, okay, what chip do I need? What pieces do I need here and there? It's a lower barrier to entry. So it's lower cost, it's, you know, lower experience level. And at Altium, we're taking care of it. In Geppetto, we're taking care of that lower level stuff and making it easier for you to design. And knowing that everything that you see in there has been tested and we know it is confirmed to work. Part of our development and our prototyping and production is we have an integrated functional testing. So boards aren't just tested electrically, you know, bed of nails type thing. These are actually functionally tested. So when everything's finished, you receive a board that the cameras work, they're streaming video, Ethernet's working, everything is functionally test before you receive it. Another nice bit, again, time to market type of thing, is the device tree support. So when in Geppetto, that this doesn't actually come after the fact, this is as you're designing, there are buttons inside of Geppetto that you can click and download the actual device tree as you're going along and building boards. So you get this, you'll be able to download a device tree, and in Torizon, you'll be able to directly take that device tree and put it into Torizon and get the software up and running. So what we feel this is a super cost-effective way of getting up and running, taking your idea, your prototype, whatever, and getting it into production without lots of the overhead. So with that, I'm going to pass things off to my colleague Keith, and Keith's going to run you through a bit of a demo to show exactly how easy it is to develop this.
Thanks, Andrew. So to build on what Andrew said, Geppetto has this fantastic drag and drop interface for building hardware. The idea is to reduce the cost and the engineering cost as much as possible in order to get your product in hand. So once it's in hand, you also know that it's been tested functionally, and it's ready to go and fully assembled, and you can get it in as few as 15 business days. Let's go to, so here, this is the Geppetto interface. This is your workspace. And as you can see, I have a few Toradex modules listed on the side here. And I can start from a blank slate and just drag and drop everything that I need. You see the module comes up red here. What that means is that there are requirements of this module that need to be satisfied before it's fully functional. And now that it's yellow, you know that everything's on the board that it needs. It just needs to be connected. There you go. Now it's turned green. And once all of my connections are made and nothing is overlapping, then the entire board turns green just like that. Now, this is one way to get started. There is another way, which is a little bit faster. This is called the board builder here. And as you can see, I've already added some devices into this particular design. I think I'm gonna add a proximity sensor as well there. and maybe some mounting holes on the corners. Then all I have to do is click Start Build. And there we have our board. The first thing you'll notice is there's these green trails here. They're proximity constraints for high-speed signals. And what that does is that makes sure that when the board gets routed, there's enough room for these high-speed signals to meander and impedance match and all those sorts of things. Now, you can also see that all the modules on the board are still red because we're lacking power. So when I click on one of the requirements of this module, it filters the module library to give you exactly what you need close at hand. And I can just go through and add these things. We just need... just rotate it around the board, move things around. Slowly but surely, or actually quite quickly if you consider it. System enable. You can also see that all the modules that I added using the board builder are already connected to the Verdin module in a functional manner. One last thing I want to add, because I add it to every board, is a USB to UART connection. And you can see all the categories of modules that are available. Scroll down to vertical micro B jack, connect that to the USB UART. Oh, here you see on UART 4, there's a little penguin symbol. That's our TUX approved symbol. That means when you connect it here, you're guaranteed to get the debug UART connection. So you get your debug console. And now, almost done. There we go. Now I can save this. That'll work. Now what you can see here, I'll make it a bit bigger. Here is a 3D preview of what your final board is going to look like, right down to the giant capacitors. Let's save that. That's fine. And now up at this top bar, you can see that I can now download my board support package. Now this is automatically generated and it includes a DTS file here, but it also includes the compiled DTB that you can directly import into your Torizon Core image and flash to your Verdin. Right away. There's also an automatic documentation feature that helps you just by providing a list of connections. It's just some documentation to help you out. And you can also see the download CAD button here. Now this board is ready to order. I can just go ahead and prepare it. And you can order your boards directly through our storefront. There it is. You can see that it's $103 to me. But you can also see that price as you're building the boards. If I drop down another regulator here, since it's there, you can see the price increases to $106.65. So you can preview your price as you go along. And with that, I will pass it back to Andrew.
Okay. So this time we're gonna do another poll. So as Keith was going through and showed, we can actually design, you can download the CAD files from what you designed. Now these aren't gonna be the full source files that you can go out and just, you know, generate some Gerbers and send them off and build them. These ones are partially routed boards that are a full schematic, but the actual finished board isn't done yet. So what you get is pieced together modules that are partially routed, and then you just need to do the last bit of connection, but that's for free. That's being done in real time when you click that download CAD button. So what we'd like to know is, what is your preferred design tool? Do you use any kind of design tool? Do you use Altium Designer? Do you use Eagle or CAD? Or if you use some other one that I haven't listed here, could you put that in the chat? So if you wouldn't mind, please do that poll quick, and we'll see what everybody's using. Oh, and there it's back right there. So it looks like we've got a chunk of people that aren't using any tool. That's good. About half the folks are using an Altium Designer. A few are using Eagle or CAD, and even so, it's kind of it's a good spread. So that's pretty cool. Good to know. Now you have ordered your board through the, as Keith mentioned, you click the order button, it's gone to the store, you've got your prototype, and you're happy with it. Now I want to move on to production. And so what are your options now when you're going into volume orders? The simplest one is you go back to the store and you put a larger order in. You put, instead of ordering, you know, prototype was 12 or something like that, now you go back and order 100 or 1,000. And at Altium, when we're going through and doing that, we have different levels of volume discounts as you go to different levels of boards. The nice thing about doing it, keeping all the manufacturing with us, is essentially nothing changes from your prototype. So if you're happy with your prototype, you're happy with how it came out, the yield was good, everything was working, then why change anything up? The pricing would change based on the amount of the volume that you're ordering. But it's just, you know, it's the easiest thing to do. You just click the button and it keeps going. The same level of testing, all the boards go through the same level of testing as the prototype. They're all functionally tested. So you know that what comes out after on the volumes scale is going to be the same as what you got in the prototype. We've had customers that do want to kind of have a bit more control over things. They want to maybe move their production somewhere else. They just want to have a bit more, part in the in the action. So they elect to they want to take that design and they want to go have it manufactured elsewhere. So we do offer a path for that. We call that our manufacturing support package. And what happens there is you'd talk to our customer support manager, and they would put together a package for you that there's a pricing that a price for that board that you would get Gerber files, all the source files, the bill of materials, suggested vendors for the parts that we've gone, like kind of a first option to get them, basically everything that you would need to go and take it to somewhere else to have it built. And so the big difference between the design files you get there as opposed to the ones you get for free in Geppetto is that Geppetto ones are, the schematic is essentially the same, but the layout, as I mentioned before, are pieces that you would have to stitch together between them. And typically that's a lot of the high speed routing, some of the power routing, but when you have the manufacturing support package, you get everything. You get exactly what's being built. So that's essentially what you're paying for with that. Okay, and so on those lines on what kind of design files you would download or what kind of what you would want out of Geppetto, how important is for you, we're gonna do another poll, how important is it for you to get those design files? Do you not care at all that I don't need them, as long as I'm doing a prototype and the prototype works, I'm gonna order with you, I don't need them? Or would you prefer to have the more functional blocks, which is what Geppetto gives you for free as you're going, kind of in real time? or would you, do you need the full complete design files? I want to see every little piece that's happening in there, and I want to see how you're routing it. So take a second to please make a selection there. Let's see. So everybody's interested in getting some sort of design files, and that's basically what we've seen. And some people are okay with the functional, but a lot have the design files, want the full ones. And I think based on what we know about Toradex customers, that makes a lot of sense. So, and what we're doing right now is we're offering a promotion that you essentially are waiving the NRE. So when you go and build a board and order it, you're saving on the engineering file, the engineering costs of getting those prototypes done. Or actually, if you're going straight to, you know, higher numbers, that's wouldn't call a prototype, but essentially you're missing those engineering costs, which it's on for a limited time right now, but that's roughly a $2,000 the savings. So essentially what you're going to be paying for is just what Keith showed you, that cost per board. I think with that, I'm handing it back to Daniel, I believe. Yeah.
Yes, thanks a lot, Andrew. And now we reached our question and answer session. So for the people who joined a little bit later, there is a question field where you can type your answer, and we will pick them up here and try to answer all of them. So please enter them now. Okay, let me get started here. So first question, how do I make a custom header? So is it possible to make custom headers?
I'll let Keith, kind of do a quick demo on that. That's something we get quite often from customers.
Yeah, there's definitely the ability to create custom headers. So yeah, there is a feature where you can, yeah, here we go. Now I'm sharing. Okay, so in here, we have headers. If we want to make a custom header, I can drop down, say, this 3-pin terminal block, and I can just add a bus that I want to provide through there. Let's just start with a GPIO. And I can just drag that onto one of the pins of the header, just like that. And then what about power? Let's provide some power to the external. And then if I want ground, I just use the little arrow on the side here, and I've created a custom 3-pin terminal header that I'll just give no name at all. Oh, I already have one named that. As you can see, then I just have to connect these pins. And there you go. That's it.
Okay.
Should note, actually, so this has come up kind of just recently. An example of why you might is Keith went through one with a screw connector, some sort of terminal block. But an interesting one that customers have been asking recently are things like mini PCI M.2 connectors, where the pin definition kind of is every pin on them are defined, but depending on if, say, you're putting a solid state drive in, an NVMe drive, or you're putting in a Ethernet adapter or a Wi-Fi card, the kind of pin requirements are a little bit different. So one single, if we had an M.2 connector for one function, you would have to either we fill out all those pins and then you'd have to connect all them, or we'd have to do one specific module for each function. And that's kind of what we've gone to with the custom modules is now if you've got a Wi-Fi connector, you can say, no, I only need these PCIe buses or this USB bus and some power, and that's it. Don't worry about the other, you know, 40 pins. So the custom headers is a super handy thing so that you can really pick and choose what you want and how you want to connect things.
Okay, thanks a lot. So next question is, can the platform also generate carrier boards with FPGAs?
So we don't have any FPGAs in Geppetto at the moment. We have been looking into it, and it's something that we can that we are interested in doing in the future. We just haven't selected any FPGA yet, but it's definitely something that's kind of on the horizon that we could be adding. And with anything, if we are constantly adding new modules that as customers need something that just isn't in Geppetto, it's really just sending an email, a chat, whatever to our customer representative and asking, can we add this into the system? And depending on how the urgency of it, there may or may not be a cost associated with, but we try to kind of take those requests and get them taken care of as soon as possible.
Okay, thanks. Who are your partner in India for prototype building and manufacturing?
So we currently don't have any offshore. I shouldn't say that. Most of our manufacturing occurs in the United States. We've got some on the East Coast and the West Coast. We do some overseas manufacturing of some components, but we are expanding all the time and changing on what we're doing. And it also varies depending on the timeline. So we have, why we do a lot of stuff domestically in the United States is because we can get quick terms. So we can go from a design to actually functioning prototype shipped to the customer in about 15 days. And occasionally it has happened, we can do quicker than that. So that's why we tend to keep things domestic. And when there's a longer lead time, higher volume, then we try to look elsewhere just to keep down costs. But generally that's how we go. So in India, nothing yet. But that's not, there's no reason why it might not change in the future.
Okay. Thanks a lot. So next question, when will the Apalis family be available in the module library? So maybe I can take that. So we actually already looked at Apalis, but we prioritized the Verdin. So you can see now Verdin works, and I think next will be the Apalis. I don't have a deadline here, but I think you just sign up to our newsletter and then you will see that pretty soon. And if you have a need or something, very urgent, let us know. Altium is very responsive and we can move pretty fast. Good. And then let me see. How long is the Altium promotion till? So maybe I also can take that. It's not a fixed line. It's basically as long as we have stock or allocated for that. So it's basically first come, first serve. If you see a huge demand, it's maybe a little bit shorter. If the demand is a little bit lower, it goes a little bit longer. Pick here. Do you have a Udemy style course free paid to get the semi-pro Geppetto designer level? So do you provide any training for Geppetto, or if somebody wants to getting an expert on Geppetto, what do you recommend?
So there's kind of different levels. We have a chat window that runs in Geppetto that you can kind of ask, I'm not saying basic questions, but it's kind of straightforward. I'm looking for this. I'm looking for this. How do I do this? If there's something a little more advanced, a lot of times, actually, Keith has been doing training for some of our partners, and it's kind of on a bigger scale. So he's been doing recordings and kind of putting together manuals that partners can use. That's more of a enterprise type thing. But generally, the quickest thing to get, how do I do this, is through the chat window. But if there's a bigger need for it, where we have resources and methods to kind of do some training, and we're expanding that all the time.
Also, what's really nice on the tool, it's very intuitive, so really just give it a try and you may be surprised how far you get there without kind of formal training.
There's also a YouTube channel, Gumsticks YouTube channel, that has a lot of introductory videos that sort of go through the process and tell you about the different features that are available. So that's a really great way to get started too.
Okay, good, thanks. Then what sort of support do you provide for real-time application? Is it easy to analyze and estimate performance needs? Maybe I can take that. I think it's mostly a software question. So yes, a lot of our customers do real-time. So it's our models are popular for a target for soft PLCs, for example, EtherCAT and so on. And there are different ways how you can realize real-time. So probably the straightforward way, and the one I also mentioned as an option for Torizon is the RT patch. And we have some measurements, some logs, some documentation about what you can expect, and you know how you can further tweak it. If you really need hard real time, so if somebody would die if it's not on time, there are also other ways to do that. So most of our modules have integrated microcontrollers, and you can run them bare metal or with an operating system called FreeRTOS. So you can provide even lower latencies, and you can be, you know, hard real time. So just get in touch with Toradex, or you know, type real time on our developer page, and I think you will find already a lot of things. Then the Geppetto, is the Geppetto software tool free?
Yeah, it's absolutely free. And so we've shown some of the things here that, you know, you can go through and design and not buy anything, but you still get value out of what you're doing. Things like if you're not interested in buying, but you want to, you know, figure out how to connect certain things, do some schematic work, Geppetto provides you with that for free. If you've already got a design and you're not really sure how to the device tree and how to get things up and running, you can connect similar modules, and the DTB that you get out could very well work for what you're doing. It's a different board, but if you connect it the same way, it's possible that now you've just got a Linux device tree for your board without doing any work other than dragging and dropping. So there's a lot of very cool things that you get from Geppetto, and they are absolutely free. There's no cost to you until you actually are ordering something and you're going to get something in your hands.
Okay, thanks a lot. So the next question is, if it fails, I assume the board. So if the board fails, what happens? Who is responsible?
So all of our boards do go through a functional test, and nothing ships without actually passing these tests. And they're recorded in our system, so we can track it back based on some sort of unique ID and know. We have a log of the test that was run and confirming that everything was passed. But ultimately, if it, you know, it does happen where those boards get sent and for one reason or another they don't work, we have a system in place that you can RMA it and it'll come back, we'll run the test again and confirm that something is or is not working. And there's a replacement or we'll rebuild, but ultimately we're concerned about making sure that your design and what you're trying to build gets, you know, that gets built properly. So if there is a problem, even if it's a design problem, we'll work with you to fix it and figure out what's the right way forward.
Thanks. Next question is about training again. So that seems a hot topic, but I think we answered that. I want to know how to get training on Geppetto. What is the process that my board will go through after I ordered it? So basically, right. I guess what happens when I press order?
Yeah, after you hit order. So essentially, it gets put into our system kind of in a queue, and one of our engineers will initially, before any work is really done to it, just take a look at the design, because occasionally people do things like, because some of the stuff you can do in Geppetto is electrically okay, sometimes it doesn't make a whole lot of sense practically. And Keith highlighted one thing when he put his the console port on there. And there are kind of some messages you'll get in Geppetto when you click order that kind of says, hey, are you sure you don't want to put this on here? Are you sure you don't want to do this? There's some suggestions. And one of them is a console, a debug port. And you can do it without it. And not only putting that on there, but also connecting to the right spot. Because as we know, these comms have, they have a default debug port. And so yes, you can connect a console port to, or a USB to UART to whatever, any UART you want. If you're looking to debug something, it only makes sense to put it to a certain on a certain UART port. So generally, we kind of go through an inspection, just high level, look at, yeah, this looks like doesn't everything make sense what they're trying to do. And then our engineers go through, do the final routing, do that last little bit of work that as you, if you downloaded those files from Geppetto, what you'd have to do, we go through and do that. Do any final checks, confirm that the board is ready to go, and then the order goes in. It's built in, depending on volume and the type of order it was, however many days. And then when it comes off the production line, it's tested and comes back to our shipping warehouse, is packaged up and sent out to you.
Okay, thanks. Then, are these board EMC compliant or guaranteed?
So no, we don't guarantee anything. We do our best effort to mitigate any kind of issues that we foresee. And we have we're following rules of thumb, standards, whatever we can to guarantee it, but there is no testing done. We're not doing any simulation. We don't have we're not using tools to confirm it. Experience tells us that the way we are laying things out, because as you can see, some of the stuff in Geppetto is a bit conservative. For that reason, we've had good results with customers that have gone compliance testing and confirming that everything is okay, that we've never seen any problems yet, knock on wood. If things come up, we are definitely willing to work with the customer and kind of solve any issues.
Okay. Yeah, because I see just here a related question to the question before, what happens if it fails? It seems it was not about an RMA case. It was more like if EMC fails, what then happens? Okay, good. Then can I define custom BCB layers while designing?
Custom, no. So Geppetto is essentially pretty well locked down on, we have a set design, and this is how we get our costs down. This is how we get the able to do things in a shorter amount of time, is because we're kind of constraining several of the parameters that in designing. Basically, most of our Geppetto boards are 6 layers. And we usually don't stray too far from that. I'm not saying it's out of the question, but generally that's just so that we can get stuff into customers' hands reliably and on time. We tend to stay with that.
Who actually makes the Geppetto prototypes, Toradex or Altium?
So these are actually built by Altium.
Okay, then does GUMP6 provide basic FW for controller-based custom board? Firmware for controller-based custom boards. So I'm not 100% sure if they mean. So for the software on the module, on the Toradex module, you can use the Toradex operating system with the configuration file, the device tree file, and that would get you running for the main module. So if that was your question, that's kind of answered. Also, Geppetto has a Linux distribution where you can use to try it out. So maybe that was the question. The other question was if you put maybe a microcontroller on the carrier board. I think you have options there too, right, Andrew?
Yeah, we do have some options that, depending on what it is, most of which are Arduino. We've got some options there. We use some of the upstream ESP, I forget the company, but the ESP upstream software that we support on some of the ESPs and ESP32, but there is options.
Okay, good. So I have a bigger question here, so I just tried to read it and let's see if we can answer that. Why is there an output level and power line for the connector? I run into issues if I set 2 internal signals on one connector, the power line and output would conflict, and I had to stick to 1 signal per connector. It looks like you just run into the problem when you're doing your custom connector and quickly closed it out.
Okay, so I did run into that problem, but I didn't close it out because of that. I wanted to get back to the questions, there are sometimes some issues with the custom connectors, and it's just because there's an infinite number of possibilities to how you can pin out these custom modules. And if you do run into problems and your header isn't connecting the way you expect it to, just open up that chat window or send us an email, and we'll make sure that your board is connected exactly the way you want it.
Okay, thanks a lot. And good, I think slowly we get through here. Let's see if I forget some. I think that was related. There were some more. What is the manufacturing fee for?
Right, we get this question often, because just depending on the user's experience, they might not know, you know, why is this so high? Because it seems like it's a lot of money if you're trying to order, you know, 5-6 boards, and there's a $2,000 fee. And that's not something we're making money on. That's just to cover the cost of stencils, the SMT programming, the just getting things, you know, when you're ordering the PCBs, if you're only ordering a few PCBs, then there's some overhead just the fact to get those PCBs made. So it's really just, it's to have those, just to have, to be able to build everything. And it's not a cost that we're trying to make money on. That's not the idea. It's just to cover our cost on getting things built.
Okay, then, you know, the question, what are future feature additions planned for Geppetto?
I think the biggest request or complaint that people get from us is that they don't have what they want in Geppetto. We don't have a certain module, we don't have this or that, and that's why we are completely open, and we just built it into our workflow that if you don't have something there, just ask and we'll add it in. So that's always something that we're expanding things more and more. We're trying to add cooler modules, there's going to be some changes and some options on the view on what you can see and how kind of lifelike it is. That will be rolling out in a little bit. We're trying to, right now, Keith showed you that you can see a 3D view of your board being built, and you can download that file. Right now, it's in a mesh format. It's not in a STEP or an IGS file. So we're going to be switching that. So you'll actually get the 3D CAD file that you can, you know, build a case around, or you can use. Right now, the STL file aren't as helpful as people would like. Apart from that, it's just trying to expand our library and get as many things in as we can.
Okay. Yeah, the next question here related, how do I request a peripheral module? So I interpret, just ask.
Right. Yeah, just ask, yeah.
Good. See here, does Altium perform signal power integrity on boards ordered by users?
So we're not doing, there's no analysis of that. It's really just functional testing. We're not doing a lot of in-depth analysis of the signals.
Okay. Next one, kind of interesting. Must the board be shaped always rectangular?
Right now, yeah, that's actually a good question. That is something that we are working on, is being able to define a custom shape.
Okay, good. So I think we are really slowly getting it here.
I should actually add to that. I think you can make circular boards right now, because you can define a corner radius. And I think if you define that radius large enough, you can actually make a circle.
Yeah, I was just going to mention that. I've seen some pretty round designs.
Okay, you found the workaround. Very good. Good. How do I find the modules I'm looking for in Geppetto?
I can take that. So when you're in the Geppetto interface, the module library is a sidebar down the right-hand side. And at the very top of it, there is a search field where you can just start typing what you're looking for, and it'll filter the library as you write. Additionally, the library is divided into categories. So if you go to view all categories, you can see that you'll be able to find USB components, sensors, power and connectors, headers and like converters and camera connectors and everything like that. And you'll be able to find it easily through the categories.
Okay, thanks. Does your functional testing include performance testing?
Generally, no. Do the pieces work? So we're not doing any kind of not durability. You know, running for X number of hours. It's really kind of booted up. Does all the pieces work? And things like, say for instance, Ethernet. We're checking the functionality of it, but we wouldn't actually check. Okay. How fast are we actually communicating? It is a much lower level thing. But again, we're not, because we have a pretty good platform for testing. And so, and we do this often with customers that when they do their prototype aren't super concerned, but when they do higher volumes, they're worried about, okay, I need this added to your test. I need to really check this or that. The software that we use to test to do the functional testing on our board is very flexible, so that if there is something that you're concerned with that you want to make sure, you know, make sure that it is performing exactly the way you want, we can add that to our test. So the tests aren't nailed down. We definitely can to adjust to suit your needs.
Okay, thanks. The next one. Does Geppetto support flex PCB designs, or basically can a user ask for a customized PCB material?
We've never done that before. The kind of the extent that we've gone with changing the PCB is the color. So that would be, I think that's just a little out of our wheelhouse right now. That would be very cool to do, but it's just not something we're set up to do right now, unfortunately.
Yeah, thanks. All the components used on a customized boards are checked for end of life.
Yeah, we maintain. As you can imagine, a lot of these components are shared across our boards, customer boards. So our kind of parts management system, we're trying to keep on top of it, that knowing when parts are going end of life. And as they go end of life, we are trying to, we have backups that we can swap out whenever possible. And we try to kind of let customers know that, you know, oh, this part is having a longer lead time as it comes up. So generally anything you see in Geppetto that you can use, we've checked it, we've confirmed that it's, you know, our normal standard lead time. But occasionally, and this has just actually come up recently, where we've got some parts, they're still not end of life, just the lead time has gone through the roof. And so we swapped out some modules, we've changed them slightly, and let customers know and saying, hey, you've built with this. If you want to do in the future, you're going to have to know there's a longer lead time on this one part, or we'll give them a hand redesigning or replacing it, changing whatever needs to change so that we can eliminate that long lead time.
Okay, thanks so much. I think we got most of the question. In case you have question we couldn't answer, or you know, popping up later, feel free to get in touch with us, either, you know, use Toradex support or get directly in touch with Altium. As mentioned, they also have a nice chat feature in the tool itself. Maybe we'll give this a try. And with that, I would like to thank you all for sticking around, asking questions. And I really hope you give this a try. and see if that fits. Let us know how it goes. Thanks so much. And also Andrew and Keith, thanks so much for joining us today. And everybody have a great day.
My pleasure. Thank you.